Today we are skating parallel to the Danube River on the scenic cycle path. The Valhalla Memorial is always worth a visit, so we put our shoes in a backpack. Today I'm skating once more at the Paraslide Hardcore Evo with 125mm wheels. My goal is to find out if I can keep up with Claudia and her almost new Rollerblade E2 110mm skates. After climbing up to the memorial on top of the hill, we found not only a gorgeous view, but also a hard yet comfortable place to relax before the second half of our 22km trip. Claudia has spent more than 100km in her E2 skates by now. In another cozy picnic area down by the riverside, she took the time to answer some questions about her experience with the new rollerblades. What is the main difference between your old four-wheel fitness skates and the Rollerblade E2? I would say the main difference is that these skates roll especially smoothly on rough pavement. In this respect, the big wheel skates are very suitable for long distances, because floor unevenness is being absorbed miraculously. This is, in any case, one of their greatest advantages. Moreover, compared to the four small wheels, I find them significantly faster without having to overexert myself. It is simply more fun skating them. I also have the feeling that on four smaller wheels, tiny pebbles can throw you out of balance much more easily than it is the case on big wheels. How much bigger is the boot size compared to your usual shoe size? I chose half a European size bigger because, in my experience, your feet get wider over the years. I had bought my old inline skates back in the 90s, when I certainly had a different shoe size. These are now the same size as my current hiking boots. But I think you shouldn't select a bigger size, because your feet would be too loose in there. Does the rigid carbon shell compromise your comfort level or even cause pressure points in areas where the shape doesn't fit 100%? Or does the padding make up for that? I have the impression that they don't break in much if you wear them for a longer time span. In order not to get pressure points, you have to figure out how to lace them up to make them comfortable. In the very beginning, I thought I had to lace them up very tightly to achieve a particularly good power transfer. But after only 5km, I was taught better, because my feet simply got numb in the front foot area. The reason is probably that you shouldn't lace them up too tightly, and also shouldn't pull the flap too firmly. But I also have a characteristically high instep, so I have to make sure that the lacing isn't too tight in this area. I also got one pressure point on my right ankle. No blisters so far, but pressure points here. So I don't close the upper buckle too firmly. Thus, I generally come to terms with it a bit better. Every time, however, I have to decide once again how to lace them. That's not a flaw of the boot, but of this boot shape in general. I don't believe it is product related. How about the weight? Yes, it is indeed notably lighter. You realize that it is very comfortable. When you skate, you don't have the feeling that you carry gold bars on your feet. What is your next kilometer goal? Well, regarding stamina, I would like to skate 50 kilometers. But for getting used to it and developing some thicker callus, you have to progress gradually. Now I have easily reached a feel-good distance of 20 to 25 kilometers. We've already skated 30 kilometers, and eventually 40 kilometers will be next. I think jumping up to 50 kilometers doesn't make a lot of sense, because if you do catch a blister somehow, the fun will end quite abruptly. Is there anything else worth reporting? I don't regret the purchase. It's really fun again to roll along on inline skates. It is not my main type of sport, but I enjoy it tremendously. And I can also imagine rolling marathon distances with these. And because I prefer such loose lacing, I can also imagine that I might get used to it and finally remove the cuff completely, because I can control it quite well. Thank you very much.